at the ash yard today. Very busy. I think we have some orientation flights going on. Beautiful day for mid-October. Kind of behind the ball, but we're going to put feeders on today. 2-to-1 sugar. And we're going to check the status of this little hive. See how they're doing since I moved them into a tin frame. I just saw pollen going in, so that's a good sign. So let's get to it. So, I don't have a big feeder on this, but I'm going to probably end up putting a rapid because I haven't really used it yet. Take that back, air up in there. I don't have any smoke going. I don't think I'll need it. Heavy frame of honey. Doing anything with that old frame. Lots of nectar around what's left of that emerging brood. Little nurse bees. There's some larvae. So there's a queen. She's laying in the last 7 days. More capped brood. A couple of larvae. Nurse bees are little fuzzy yellow heads. Looks like I got some eggs at the top there. Oh yeah, there's some. Lots of eggs, so she might be ramping up. Speak of the devil, there she is. I'll probably have to go in and mark where she's at. But didn't see her last time, it made me nervous, but you won't see your queen every single time. Alright, this little colony is doing well. I don't like wearing gloves on working bees, but in the fall, sometimes they can be a little spicy. So I'm going to be protecting their stores. Somebody just stung me there, didn't go through the glove. These girls buttoned back up. Had a couple of freezes the past couple of nights, so we're pretty much probably going to get ready going to birth. I get set up for the next thing, getting all these feeders ready. So robbing is definitely an issue. It's obvious. Bees just start moving in when you open a hive. So what I'm going to do is just go through and remove all these top covers. Excuse me, inner covers. Because with the rapid top feeders, they don't need to be, they don't need the inner cover. I'm going to put this one back inside this hive because that rapid round will fit right inside. Maybe I'll do that first and be done with this one. It fits nice in there. So I'm going to have to definitely keep checking for keeping this one filled because they'll eat that up quick. Already in there. All right. Go through and get the rest of these inner covers out. I've got that one already. So two down, three go. Lots of propolis this year. I don't know if a lot more tree sap and so they're using it more, or if they know something's coming that we don't as far as weather. This inner cover's stuck inside. Propolis is kind of sticky. All right, another thing I'm going to do, I forgot to do to the small hive. I've got some probiotic super DFM for honeybees and some APT, which is an all-round feed. They look like, I call them urinal cakes, but supposed to help with everything from digestion, pest management. So guys that I've been watching this, it's amazing what it's doing for varroa mites, the drops they're seeing. So hopefully that'll help along with my oscillic acid treatments. So got my 2-to-1 sugar water ready. Only 25 pounds, so I have to spread it evenly and get some more made up because they'll go through it. Let's start with this end hive, give them a tablet. These tablets won't fit under an inner cover very well, so with these feeders on, it shouldn't be a big deal, but you almost need the, if you use inner covers, yeah. Or if you run those kind of inner covers that, there's another sting, inner covers that, like the ground one side. One down, 5.5 to go.